The Spartan five coming out of the break. Holman, Person, Clements, Adele, and McLaughlin. As Holman going to work with Clements on the elbow. Didn't want it. Back out to Holman. Patrolling that right wing. Working over to his left and trying to find a way to get around the zone D of the Eagles. With Adele in between the circles. Person out for three. Short. As Will Trawick chases down the glass. And the Eagles will now look to add to their four-point lead. The Eagles led by as many as eight, and there is Alex Foster, the senior out of Portland, Oregon, laying it in. Foster had a bit of a quiet first half. He had seven in 14 minutes on 2-of-5 shooting. But now he's got nine. And Adele is going to shoot over Foster as Adele gets the mid-ranger to go. Your score 38-34. Spartans still trailing by four with a minute and seven gone in period number two. David Rayo bouncing it down low. Foster turn to face. Fadeaway jumper, no good. Long rebound claimed by Florin. Passing up on that three. Foster ran into a wall. Had it rejected. Three different red uniforms were there to deny the lay-in attempt by the leading scorer in the UAA. Spartans the chance to come within two or as few as one. Adele turning his back to the rim. Here he goes. Strong right hand. Adele cannot get the finish. It goes in and out. Florin has had himself a busy night working on Holman. Steps away in the paint. The roll will not go. And the Spartans were the last to touch. Emory will keep it. They will also get a fresh shot clock. That's Jason Zimmerman, eighth-year head coach for Emory. Has had his Emory Eagles with a solid 2014-15 season at 17-5 overall. Sean McDonald opposite him. His Spartans are 15-7. As the boys in gold working against the boys in red. As Florin off of the curl, now using the screen, having trouble going against Adele, tripped up there. It is a cough up for the Eagles and another opportunity for Case Western Reserve. Person using both arms, trying to shake off the D. Here comes Jimmy Holman. Now Person, little give and go. McLaughlin too hot for him, he gets it back out to Jimmy Holman for three, short. Person gets an easy offensive board. Holman giving the D a look. There's a nice give and go. Adele with a fist bump and Clements with the finish. How about the synergy between the two senior big men? 3 minutes gone by. The interior passing from Clements to Adele has made it a two-point game. The reverse layup attempt by Shady. But the make by Alex Foster. The follow-up by the senior forward at 6'8" brings it once again to a four-point game. Adele giving a look. Clements up and under. Nice move. Brian Clements. They've got something working between the two of them, Clements and Adele, the interior passing. Once again, making it a one-point game. There is a Emory turnover. More importantly, a steal for the Spartans as they forced that turnover. McLaughlin wanted room for three, but elected not to. Person has some options. Clements set that screen. Now they're trying to get to Clements again. Adele got to that spot of the baseline where he's been passing, and Clements has picked up the pace on the offensive end. And he will go to the line. A trio of Eagles coming in. Witt Rapp, freshman guard coming in. Jonathan Terry coming in. Also Austin Duggio coming in. As David Black returns to the game. Pardon me, that's Eric Black. number 21. There's McLaughlin with room for two. And McLaughlin finds the stroke to tie this baby up at 40 apiece. Back to work, all the Eagles. Been a while since we've been tied, although the Spartans have not had a lead. Trying to get it to Terry. Terry working on Person. And a whistle will stop play right there. The foul against the Spartans, their first. With 15:35 to play. Again, the zone. And the three from Foster. Alex Foster rising up from beyond the arc and knocking it down. Foster now with double figures in points. He's got 12. And the Eagles go back on top by three. Look at Holman. Foot on the gas. As Dugio got a piece of the ball, but it is a violation against the Eagles. It is a goaltend, so they will give Holman the basket. And the Spartans back to within one. Eagles led by as many as eight, but now, ever since, it has been neck and neck. Spartans sticking with them. Rising for a deep two. Austin Dugio is off of the mark. And the boys in red will take it away. Looking to go on top. They have not led in this game. Eric Black out to Person. Head faked that three. And it will go back out to Jimmy Holman. Hand in his face. Holman rising for two. No, sir. Rebound, David Rayo. Looking to push. Terry dropped the ball. Tries to put it in off the glass. Tough lay-in. Jonathan Terry somehow finds a way to make it happen. The sophomore guard out of Greensboro, North Carolina, has his first two of the half and a 3-point advantage for Emory. A whistle right in front of the Spartan bench. It is a foul against Emory. Team's second foul. That will force the UAA's leading scorer, Alex Foster, to sit in his fourth year out of Portland, Oregon. Black went up to get the ball. Here comes Eric. Head fake move, blocked. Austin Dugio got all ball on that play. And the Eagles will try to once again go up by two possessions. Well, they can slow things down and start things up right when they want to. The lay-in by Josh Shady. He has been involved in a number of ways for the Emory Eagles. McLaughlin, an open triple. There it is. Dane McLaughlin has his fourth triple of the game. He has already owned the school's three-point shooting record. And coming into today's action was seven shy of tying Tim Chung's Case Western Reserve single season record of 75. Well, he's now just three shy of tying that single season record at 75, so he will obliterate that record. Will Dane McLaughlin. McLaughlin, the 2015 Capital One Academic All-District selection. He ranks eighth on the Spartans' career point list with 1,281. Of course, that does not take into account what he has scored today. He has scored in double figures yet again. As McLaughlin, your leading scorer on both accounts with 17 points, including 4 of 7 from three-point range. Using a bunch of curls, the Eagles trying to draw something up with just a two-point lead. The fall away for two, Austin Dugio, able to get a tough one to go. 49-45. Jordan Dean is back into the game for Case, along with Matt Clark and David Black. There he is, trying to hit his brother. Nice hesitation, and the finish Eric Black receiving that pass from his brother, and it gets it done. Eric Black using that length to climb the ladder. And the Spartans within two. Look at that spinning move and a spinning bucket. The finish by Austin Dugio. David Black almost lost the ball. Got it to his brother Eric. Eric coughed it up. And the Eagles pull it away. There is a three. It is in and out. Jonathan Terry with the miss. And the Spartans the rebound. Clark tried to finish. Well defended there by the Eagles. They will have Rayo and Witt Rapp coming off of the floor as they approach the 12-minute mark. Ball is up for grabs. It is taken away by the Eagles. Here they come in transition as they will settle into the half-court offense, and somebody took a big plunge right there. Will Traick slid about 10 feet on the floor. It's a Spartan foul. It is Jordan Dean, the guilty Spartan. It is his first, and the Spartans have their second foul. Little bit of moisture on the floor. This is where Dean collided with the Eagles defender right there. So the Eagles really do not want to surrender this lead. They haven't wanted to surrender the lead. The Spartans have been able to really stay within six for the better part of the game. They trail as many as eight. Look at this long three by Alex Foster. It is no good, and Jordan Dean was bumped by Josh Shady, who has been a very aggressive defender. It is going to be an Eagles foul against Shady. There's a Spartan bench right there. Most of the seniors off of the floor. Look at the pass by David Black. Eric Black cannot get it to go. How about that aggressiveness as David Black was inbounding to the left of his bench in front of his coach and basically threw up an alley-oop, but his brother Eric Black couldn't get it to go. Eagles going to work. Little dump and go. Shady tries to put it up, and nice defensive play. It was bottled up by the Spartans. Shot clock is frozen at 19 as Julian Person coming into the game to replace the great Dane, Dane McLaughlin. They'll go right underneath the rim. Trapped was Jonathan Terry, but they found a way to avoid the trouble. And Florin, bottled up by Person. Now it is Eric Black working. Swatted away! Alex Foster. Layup attempt was blocked by the freshman from St. Ignatius, but Emory will keep it. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Good thing you have Florin as the inbound passer. He's been creating havoc from a creating standpoint. It's Foster for two. Nope. Florin almost took that rebound away from Julian Person, but instead Person will take it away, and the Spartans will set up. Give and go from Dean to Julian Person. On an ISO, Person defended by Foster, and not going to be Spartans' ball. Person lost the hand. No Eagle was last to touch, so the Person turnover will mean Emory basketball. Emory basketball coming all the way from Atlanta, Georgia, a regular UAA opponent of the Spartans, making the long trip, and the miss lay-in by the Eagles. Clark was dribbling the other way, and he fell to the floor, picked up a foul, adding to the Eagles' total. As look at this, all of these starters coming back in for Case. There's Jimmy Holman right there leading the charge. The junior point guard along with McLaughlin. He's in the shot as well. He's back on the floor. Clements is back in. Connor Adell is back in. Time for the seniors to get their work in for the Spartan Club. All seniors with the exception of Jimmy Holman. He is a junior. Person going around the D. Gave it to Clements. Clements taps it in. Person and Clements in the two-man game. We'll make it a two-point game as we get down to the 10-minute mark. And a kickball violation. They tried to get it down to Austin Duggio. Only 8 seconds come off of the shot clock, so still plenty of time for the Eagles to work with. Spartans in the half-court press. We'll go man-to-man, trying to look for some ball pressure. It is down low. It is Foster working on Clements, now kicking it out to the three-point line, and the misfire by the Eagles gives it back to Holman and company. Holman staring down the D. He's going to rise up for two. It is in and out. Whistle is going the other way. Going to be a Spartan foul. It is Clements' second foul. Spartans' third. 9:38 to play at the Adelbert Gymnasium on Throwback Weekend. I am Eddie Jansen. Ron Jans is going to be back with us on Sunday for the Rochester doubleheader. Terry, a quick rising three. He missed everything. And the Spartan faithful will let him know it. Yeah, you can see him right there giving Jonathan Terry an earful. Terry had 6 forced turnovers in Emory's win against Chicago, 4 steals and 2 blocks. But defensively, they have figured him out here today. Person on the give, stepping into the passing lane was Davis Rail, and it is another Spartan turnover. And at the other end, a quick finish. The clock stopping with 9:04. There is Michael Florin. He has had his work cut out for him today. He's been working hard at the senior guard. Free throws coming. Florin had 6 free throw tries in the first frame, and he gets another one, and it will be a Jason Zimmerman timeout. He wants to talk it over with his Eagles. 54-49, the Eagles atop the Spartans. 9:04 left to play. Still plenty of basketball headed your way here on Media Vision. Don't go anywhere. At the Adelbert Gymnasium, it is Throwback Weekend here in University Circle. Welcome back, everyone. Eddie Jansen on play-by-play duties tonight. Ron Jans will be back with us on Sunday for the 2 contests against the Rochester Yellow Jackets. The Spartan women with yet another 1-point loss to the Emory Eagles as Clements tries to throw in a three. He got his own miss, puts it back in. Brian Clements with the hustle play as he gets the offensive board. And that one back tapped away as Connor Adell was able to get it. And Sean McDonald, Spartans head coach, is pleading his case for what I believe would be a clear path foul. But to my knowledge, I do not know if they call those in the NCAA or not, but it would have been a clean lane right to the rim for Adell, who's been playing well offensively in transition. And they still have not made a decisive call right here as the Spartans have been hanging around. They have always been able to stay within six of the Eagles. The Eagles' biggest lead was at eight. You see the energy from Will Trawick trying to deny that entry pass, but it finds Holman, and Holman gets it into the forward court. Clements looking for a cutting person, but wisely passed it up. Holman to his left, way back out to Person. Person wants a screen, now he changed his mind. With 15 to shoot, Person on the give. Clements, a long three. Adell almost grabbed that board, but instead it goes to the Eagles. Florin, two-handed firm one to Rayo. It's on the block now. Clements with both hands up. He is guarding Dugo. No on the layup, but Holman came down with it. And that will cause the official to blow a whistle here. It is an Eagles foul. They now have five team fouls as Shady and Dugio will take a seat. Clements is also going to take a seat for the Spartans. Spencer Boyd, the 6'1" third-year player out of Walsh Jesuit, checking back into the game, a defensive specialist, the head of the officiating crew. Quick check over to the scoreboard. There are some of the Spartan faithful right there. Another very good crowd for a Friday evening game here at Adelbert Gymnasium. We had a change in sight. It's not the usual sight of play for the Spartans, but still a very good crowd on hand, as they were well aware that we are coming to the legendary Adelbert Gymnasium. So a light press, full court for the Eagles. But the Spartans, the shot clock down to 25. That's the thing about the press. It takes valuable time off of the shot clock. Adell trying to make some room on the post up. Holman rising for two. That is good. Jimmy Holman rising up and knocking it down. And a one-point game. Still in favor of the Eagles, though. Here is Terry going to work on the block. No, sir. Rebound to Julian Person. We're going the other way. Spartans working to my right. Screen. McLaughlin, a triple. Well, that came out of nowhere, but McLaughlin threw in the contested three. He is now two triples shy of the single season all-time record for most threes in a year. The reverse lay-in, in and out. The Eagles with the offensive rebound, the putback by Jonathan Terry. A cold-blooded offensive cleanup for Jonathan Terry in traffic. We are knotted at 56 all. Person trying to finish too high off the glass, though. As you can see, Person right there, a little bit slow to get up right in front of the Spartan cheerleading squad. As Person had room to finish, but the contact prevented him from doing so. As the Eagles are now in the 1-and-1 bonus, Person going to the line. 80% Person on the season from the stripe. Thus far been a little bit of a quiet game offensively for Person, but with his 6'7 frame, one of the better wing defenders in the UAA, as Connor Adele is going to take a blow. And Eric Black, the freshman, will replace him in his first year out of Avon Lake. A one-point lead now for the Spartans, who are 8-2 at home. As Person has another one. And a sure-handed a free thrower as there is in the league. There he is, Julian Person with two big ones. 6:26 to play. The Spartans have a 58-56 lead as Sean McDonald will get his squad to regroup. They've got their first lead of the game with 6:26 to go. Don't go anywhere. More basketball headed your way. We are inside the Adelbert Gymnasium, originally constructed as an armory for use during World War I. However, the war ended before construction was finished, so the Adelbert Gymnasium really never used for that purpose, but we've got a great basketball game going on here. The Spartans and the number 18 Emory Eagles in the D3Hoops.com nationwide poll are trying to work against the Spartans with a deficit of two. Spartans have had their first lead of the game thanks to two Julian Person free throws. As we are now just about inside of 6 minutes to go, top one, Alex Foster. He's given them 21 points a night. And it goes without saying, he is the top scorer in the conference. We are tied at 58, under 6 minutes to play. McLaughlin swinging it around. Jimmy Holman scouting out the D. Now ball in the hands of Person, locking in defensively is Alex Foster. Here is Person for a triple, too much iron. And Black almost got that rebound, but we will have a whistle. It is an Eagle foul. It is their eighth team foul and a half. Spartans are in good company in that regard. They have just four. As Eric Black, having an outstanding freshman season at 9.5 points a game with the Spartan bench, shoots the 1-1, and he chases down his own misfire from the line. Fresh 35 for Jimmy Holman and company. Person sizing up the D. There's the Black screen. Person lost his foot. He has Boyd holding possession now, and they give up to Holman. It is Holman versus Florin. Florin's been all over the place here today. And a whistle off of the ball. Offensive foul against the Red Unis. It is the fifth team foul against Case, and they will come away empty-handed trying to get the lead back as Boyd, the best defender with the Spartans, locking in on Michael Florin, hoping for a turnover. Now the ball in the arms of Terry. Terry coughed it up, but we'll get it back, and a timeout taken by Jason Zimmerman. His team was under duress. And they will avoid the turnover and come back with 17 on the shot clock and 4:42 to play. There they go. Well, these two teams have been neck and neck for just about the entire duration of the game. The Eagles had an early 8-point lead. They have held the lead for the majority of the game, but the Spartans took a 2-point lead just a couple of minutes ago, but now we're tied at 58 apiece with 4:35 to play. Running into that double team, and a turnover for the Eagles. It was Will Trajek. He had nowhere to go with the basketball. Bringing it up, Jimmy Holman, trying to put his team on top, making a move on Foster. There is Holman again, in and out. Black was battling for the rebound, but instead Foster won it. Florin trying to go against Boyd. Boyd's their best defender. Foster thought about that three, but will elect to absorb more shot clock. Florin, now McLaughlin will switch defensively. Here is Florin. Florin does not finish. Looked like he was going to get it. Terry, the pull-up jumper, no. Offensive rebound. Foster has the offensive glasswork for Emory, has kept a long possession alive. Trajek trying to shake off Person. To the other side it goes. There is Florin. Tons of off-ball movement. Now they're going to pound it to Foster. Foster, the riser. That's a no-go on that one. Spartans will take it away with less than 3.5 minutes to play. They're looking to take the lead here and hopefully stay there for good. Person on the curl. Give and go, Black. Oh, Black finishes strong. Eric Black went right around his defender, and after that, there was little resistance from the Eagles. Eric Black now approaching double figures. He's got 9. And Boyd ends up with a ball as the Eagles coughed it up. And some late turnovers coming down the stretch run are hurting the Eagles and working to the Spartans' advantage. McLaughlin, the post up, stolen. Jonathan Terry goes up strong, and we've got a tie game. Big time transition lay-in. Jonathan Terry, the 6'1" guard, stole it away from McLaughlin and ties it at 60 apiece. Person slowing things down. Crossover three from Person and a foul. As the senior guard Person is going to go to the line for three. And a big turn of events with 2:08 to play. Person, an 80% free thrower, is headed to the line for three big ones. Ninth team foul for the Eagles as Person, probably the best free thrower on the team. And that bounced around and it went in. And the fans are giving it to Alex Foster. Tried to tip it out or what, but they are really giving him the boo birds here. As Person will have one more. I guess that shot must have been a 2. I thought it was a 3 at first, but he only gets 2 free throws. Laying it in at the other end. Florin denied. The outstanding Eagles point guard gets swatted away at the rim, and the Spartans with a chance to go up by 2 possessions here with Holman operating the offense. Minute 45 to go. Person had to give it up. Eric Black, it's on the floor. It's picked up by Florin. Here come the Eagles, down by a deuce. The fake three from Trajek. He's weaving his way into a shot. He gets the roll, and the Eagles tie it up once again. Will Trajek from Bedford, New York, with a big-time bucket there as we approach 1 minute and counting. Holman on a give and go. Person not going much of anywhere. Florin is matching him. Black setting the screen, out over to Boyd. Now they want to post up Eric Black, right back to Boyd. And another turnover. Florin stepped in the way. With under a minute to play, Michael Florin comes up with a big steal. Yeah, that's getting loud. Long three. Oh my goodness. Alex Foster in cold blood buries the triple with two hands in his face. And a big time change in momentum as the Eagles go up by three. With 40 seconds remaining, Sean McConnell and his Spartans have watched the entire complexity of the game take a different direction. How about Alex Foster? I mean, this guy is first in the UAA in scoring, fourth in rebounding, second in three-pointers. And that was a big one. Well, the good news is this game is not over. It is still a one-possession game. They will have about a 4.5-second differential between shot clock and game clock. But the Eagles protecting a three-point lead on the triple shooting from Alex Foster. So here they come. Holman, McLaughlin, Boyd, Eric Black, and Person. A strong three-point shooting team out there. As Boyd with his back to the bucket, driving against Terry, tried to go up with it, tried to dunk it. Did Boyd? Boyd is going to see free throws. Boyd was trying to go for the three-point play right there, but instead he will have to go to the charity stripe instead. Boyd has only attempted 18 free throws on the season. He has made 10 of them. But he will be guaranteed two, and there's one. But he has to make two, because if he doesn't, and the Eagles make a bucket at the other end, it could be a three-point game or as many as four. And a big missed free throw there by Boyd, but the quick foul is going to be tagged on by the Spartans. But Case Western did have a foul to give, so that is only their sixth. Clock at 24.4, now down to 23.7. And the Spartans, in the worst way possible, need at least one miss to stay alive in this game. We've got a couple timeouts remaining, though. But you do not want to see a two-possession game this late in the contest. And Alex Foster making that one there. Foster now with 15 points, has not missed a free throw. Spartans need a miss here. And they get it, but the offensive rebound. Will Trajic making the play of the game there. So the Spartans will not get the possession they needed, down by three. And Trajic, if he makes one, will make it a four-point contest and a two-possession lead for the number 18 Emory Eagles. Well, there it is. He makes the front end of two. The Eagles have hit some big-time free throws down the stretch. Got one more, and he will make twice. Jordan Dean is going to come in to stretch the floor. Spencer Boyd will come out. 20 seconds and counting. Jimmy Holman out over Jordan Dean. Here he comes. The foul on Jonathan Terry. They are in the double bonus, so Jordan Dean could make it a three-point game. And Dean, a very sure-handed free thrower, has to make twice here, does Jordan Dean. Dean at 81%. Good on the first, but he will have to make the second or else the Eagles will remain on top by two possessions. It bounced around there, but he makes twice, and Sean McDonald gonna take another timeout with 15.7 to go. The Spartans do not wanna go away just yet. And we'll have the conclusion of the game coming up after this short break. There's the Spartan faithful. They have seen a good one here at a change of venue. The Adelbert Gymnasium, probably about a quarter mile away from the home of the Spartans, still on Case Western Reserve's campus, though. Spartans did once play here many years ago. But right now, Spartans need to foul, 15.7 to go. And they got it to the right guy. They want to go to the line. Will Trawick is going to go to the line again for the Eagles. The Spartans will need two misses from Trawick as there's Jason Zimmerman. He has coached his Emory Eagles to the 18th best spot in the D3hoops.com poll. And the cell phones and the cameras were bleeping in the student section to just try to distract Trawick from making that free throw. But boy, have the Eagles been spot on from the line. There they are. That'd be pretty distracting if it was me at the line. Oh boy, they just make them look easy. I mean, those are 6, 7, maybe 8 big free throws, and all of them made by the Eagles. 5-point game. Dean out to Holman, and Holman is out of bounds. And that will just about do it. With 7 seconds to play and a 5-point deficit, it appears that the Spartans will come away empty-handed here on day number one at the Adelbert Gymnasium. They throw it in and fouled Trawick again to the line. Another timeout. We will keep it right here and we'll take a look at just a couple more games coming up. Only two of them after today. We'll be back in action on Sunday, the 22nd. As Rochester, New York comes to town. The men will tip off at 12 noon, followed by the women at 2. That will be the conclusion of Throwback Weekend. And then the final game of the 2015 season will be Saturday the 28th as Carnegie Mellon comes to University Circle. That is senior day. The women will go to action first. They tip off at 3. Followed by the men at 5. Well, barring any irregularities, the Eagles look to go to 18-5 on the season and improve upon their 18th rank in the nation. Would also put them at 8-4 in the UAA. Spartans would fall to 15-8. And an even 6-6 record. There is the foul once again. Will Trawick has been a busy boy at the free throw line. Not so much early in the game, but in the latter stretch as he has hit some big ones, and he'll have a couple of more with 5.3 to go. And the Spartans, with their win over Brandeis on Monday, and it was originally supposed to play on Sunday, but due to very inclement weather over on the East Coast, had to make the trip on Monday. The Spartans won that game. It broke a three-game skid. As don't think they're going to get the last shot off, and that is going to do it. So the Spartan men and women come up empty-handed here in the front end of Throwback Weekend as the women fell to the Eagles 61-60, and the men fall to the number 18 Emory Eagles. Your final score 71-65 as the Spartans fall to 6-6 in the UAA. They are 15-8 overall. The Emory Eagles improve to 18-5 and will take an 8-4 conference record back to Atlanta.